I'm William Cooper, and you're listening once again to the Hour of the Time. This is the only hour that ever was or ever will be. This is, ladies and gentlemen, the most important hour in your entire life. For during this hour, you will decide your future, and thus our collective futures. I have been, for many years, more than I care to even remember, attempting to wake the sheeple, empower the people, and hopefully preserve liberty for our children, and as our forefathers put it, our posterity. When I began, I had a great faith in the American people. I had a wonderful feeling that if just someone just turned their head away from the fantasy of their everyday life and the erroneous things that they had been taught and just gave them a glimpse of the truth, they would latch onto it like a thirsty man at a well who had just crossed the desert. I was very polite in those days, very nice, very forgiving, very understanding, very helpful to anyone and everyone that came along. And everybody thought I was a great fellow. Wonderful guy, that Cooper. Yep, just asking for it. He'll give you the shirt off his back. Any information that he's got, he'll give it to you. Oh, and don't worry, if you want him to come and talk, he'll come and talk for nothing. And I did. For several years, in fact. Until one day, my wife and I and our newborn daughter found ourselves standing in a ditch with nothing. You see, the sheeple of this world had sucked us dry, hadn't done any good whatsoever. None of them were active in helping find the truth. No, they would take what bits of information I gave them, bend them to fit their agenda, and take off in another fantasy, flapping their wings over the horizon. And if it had not been for some good people whom we had never met, never seen, and to this day I do not know who they are, and I have no idea how they knew that we needed help, these little envelopes arrived in the mail. With no return address, no signatures, no message, no nothing. $5 or $10, $50, $20. And we were able to get back on our feet. You see, somebody would call me and say, "Bill, we want you to come and talk to our group." And I would think, "I'll go. And I'll talk to the group, and they'll help me defer expenses, and they'll donate a little something to help us keep going." Well, I would get there, and I would speak, and they would all applaud and stand and say what a wonderful person Bill Cooper is. No donations, no help with the travel expenses, no help to put food on the table. And so one day, I said, no more. This is what I do. These people who I am exposing have made it impossible for me to work for anyone else. This is what I do, and I have a right in a free country to charge for my work. So I did, and still do. And then at one memorable gathering, I was speaking, and when it came time for question and answers, one person raised his hand and I called upon him, and he stood up and told me that the information that I had just spent several hours imparting to these people was no good, of no consequence whatsoever, and that I was discredited because he had to pay to get in to hear what I had to say. That was another milestone. My faith in the American people began to ebb. And it ebbed even further when one day in San Diego, I was giving a talk to people and trying to wake them up. And about an hour into the program, a woman stood up and began screaming at me, yelling and raving, and froth was coming out of her mouth. And she said that what was happening to us is all my fault. It's all your fault. It's all your fault. You should have told us this years ago. And she began to curse at me. And then I tried to get on the computer net. So I still am, by the way. And have been off and on over the years, but I would get on and it would begin with something innocent. I'll give you the most recent example on the internet. And usually after several of these attacks, I would just leave and would not come back, or I would use another name and just stay on the net and never make any comments. Because I've discovered that people do not like the truth, they don't want to hear the truth, especially if it pings upon one of their personal agendas, or if they belong to one of the religions or secret societies or organizations that's involved in this, and they don't want to confront it. The most recent example was there were posts about Pat Buchanan running for president on the internet. And I merely left a simple little statement stating that Pat Buchanan belonged to the Knights of Malta, and as a member of the Knights of Malta, has taken an oath of absolute obedience to the order and to the Pope. I also made the statement that the Knights of Malta is recognized by all countries in the world as an independent sovereign nation, not just an organization or a secret order, but a nation. As a member of the Knights of Malta, I said, Pat Buchanan carries a diplomatic passport for this nation of the Knights of Malta. The Knights of Malta are also well known, it's no secret, the militia of the Pope. They have two sworn allegiances, and nothing else can go over or supersede these allegiances. The first is absolute and total obedience to the order, and the second is absolute and total obedience to the Pope. When the Vatican feels that the Pope is in some special danger, or that the Vatican itself is in some special danger, the Swiss mercenary guard that is normally employed to guard the Pope and the Vatican is dismissed, and the Knights of Malta take position as the guards of the Pope and the Vatican. As a member of the Knights of Malta, Pat Buchanan could be called upon to perform this function. So I merely posed a question. Shouldn't the President of the United States have allegiance only to the United States of America and to God? And to no other country, no other person, no other organization, and no other nation? Well, I made this post very nicely, in very nice language. I made my point very well and was viciously attacked from all sides. Now, it's noteworthy that every single person who attacked me was a Freemason or a member of the Mormon Church. I had said nothing about religion, only oaths. Only oaths. But this time, I'm going to stay there. And I don't care what happens, come hell or high water, I'm going to stay there. And I'm going to continue to rub it in their nose. And this time, I'm not going to leave the net, like I have been used to doing. I have backed up every post I've made with facts. When I didn't give facts, I gave sources or references. And when I didn't do that, I told people that it's very easy to find the information. Please go do it. I even challenged these Freemasons who said that there's nothing wrong with taking an oath to the Freemasonic Lodge, and it would not hinder their ability to function as President of the United States. I challenged them to quote those oaths in public on that list on the net, and they refused. They refused because they're lying. They also take an oath that says rather than reveal the truth, they must remain silent or lie. One of the oaths, which I have in my possession, states that these people have to give shelter and aid to any brother Freemason, no matter what they have done or what trouble they are in, unless and except they have committed murder or treason. Anything else, they have to protect them. Also, there's an oath that says they have to refrain, and I'm paraphrasing it, refrain from molesting each other's daughters and wives. All other daughters and wives are fair game. I have copies of these oaths. This is not some imaginatory fantasy that I'm flighting off in. And so do many other researchers. And then later, as you get way up in the higher degrees of the Scottish Rite and the York Rite, there's another oath to say you must shelter and hide and give aid to a brother, even if he has committed murder or treason. And it also says that if any brother of the order of the Royal Arc degree is running for political office, you must vote for that brother. You cannot vote for anyone else. And the oaths demand absolute obedience to the lodge and to the master of the lodge. And that is why they will not quote the oaths. And you see, when you're on a computer net, they can hide behind their computers. Nobody knows who these people are. They can hide behind their computers and lash out. And when they can't deal with the facts, or will not deal with the facts, they make personal attacks. I just read a post that was sent to me a few minutes ago. Rather than deal with the facts that I had posted and argue a valid, intelligent argument, to present one's case logically and reasonably with facts and sources, the person raved about how many women and children I had killed in Vietnam. And I fought in Vietnam, folks. I killed a lot of men in Vietnam. I didn't kill any women and children, none whatsoever. And I sorely regret having killed anyone. And when I left Vietnam, I made an oath to myself that I would never kill another living thing as long as I lived, and I've stuck with that so far and hope to be able to stick to it until the day I die and way beyond. And there's a reason that people are like this, because people, for the most part, are mindless sheep. The Illuminati are absolutely correct. I have discovered this. It has been one of the greatest disappointments of my life to discover that most people, the people that I have been battling for, the people that I have laid my life down for you can be sure that when the New World Order comes into power, my life is forfeit for the work that I have done. It has been the greatest disappointment to find out that they are absolutely right about most of what they call the masses. Whenever you hear somebody use that term, they're usually one of them. Are nothing but cattle, sheep, mindless animals, stakes on the table and beasts of burden by choice and consent. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's true. It's because from the beginning people are taught to be stupid, taught not to think, not to challenge, taught not to ask questions.
Somebody told us what we wanted to be. It is the end of the mind. Look behind and you'll see it was circus. This high little, this cat in the
pit. I just yes.
This safe is the view. It is right down the middle. It is fantasy. Fantasy below. It is everything we ever wanted. Between that, there's so much more. Who was it to say?
Why is it that we are told when we are young that we have to go to high school and then go to work for somebody? Why aren't we taught anything about money in high school? Why aren't we told that we don't have to go to work for somebody, that we can go out and begin a business of our own and not be dependent upon other people? Why aren't we taught to think properly, to question everything as we are supposed to do? What happened to Socrates? What happened to Aristotle? Where are they when we need them? Why is it that you think you have to marry the cheerleader and have 2.5 kids, buy a brand new Chevy, and mow the lawn every weekend? Who says these things have to be, and why do you eat it up? That's what I want to know. Why do you think that just because you belong to an organization, you must defend it rather than question it, especially when you don't know anything about it? And I'm talking to all you stupid, absolutely empty-headed Freemasons out there who joined an organization you didn't know anything about because you were proselytized by a friend or a business acquaintance. And don't tell me you weren't, because that's the only way Freemasonry ever gets members. Nobody even knows it exists until somebody comes along and pats you on the shoulder and says, "John, we've been friends for 4 years. It's about time you join the lodge." Oh, and I know you all say you don't proselytize and you don't go out and recruit members or seek new members, and you are liars. I'll say it right to your face through this microphone, or if your nose was 2 inches from mine, I'll still say it. You are barefaced liars. If you didn't do that, you wouldn't have any members, and you damn well know it. For all you know, it could be an international organization for the importation and the sale of pot to all of our children. And many of you will stand up and rant and rave and say, this guy is loony. We don't sell pot. How do you know? You haven't gone through all the degrees yet. And I can assure you that even if you're a 33rd degree Freemason of the Scottish Rite, there are degrees over you. For beyond that degree, they disappear behind what is called the veil. See, I know more about your order and your lodge than most of you ever will if you live to be 210. You don't even understand most of your own ceremonies. You just go through them because that's what you got to do to get the next degree and be loved by your brothers. You are part of a subversive organization that is destroying this country from within. You see, this country is not being destroyed by some invading army. It's being destroyed exactly as our forefathers said could be the only way that it would be destroyed, and that is from within. Most of the people who have had a hand in the destruction of this great nation have been Freemasons, members of the Rosicruci, members of the Knights of Malta, the Golden Dawn, Templi Ordo Orientalis, and I could go on and on and on. B'nai B'rith, that's a biggie. And B'nai B'rith doesn't mean Jews any more than Freemasonry means Lutherans. And there's another big player in all of this that most of you have never heard about. That's the Order of St. John of Jerusalem. All of these organizations at their highest level are subversive. Their allegiance is only to the order and the worldwide brotherhood. They are citizens only of their own government and none other. And at the highest degrees, they take the oath called the Kol Nidre, and they mean it literally. It negates and does away with all other oaths. You see, the rites practiced in all of these orders were largely taken from the Jewish Kabbalah and the Jewish mysticism. And I'm not talking about a Jewish plot. Many Jews, most Jews, I should say, are not members of any of these organizations. They go about their daily life just like all of you. Well, you see, one time in history, the Jews were the only people who preserved knowledge and passed it down. And they did so in secret, simply because they were outcast, ostracized. They were forbidden to practice these things. And not all of the mysteries came from the Jews. At one time, ladies and gentlemen, the nation of Islam, headed by the Prophet Muhammad, was the greatest civilization in possession of the greatest knowledge upon the face of this earth. They had the only universities in the world at that time. And people from countries all over the world, including Europe, sent people to attend these universities because it was the only place that they could gain knowledge. The mysteries originated in the Middle East and have spread across the world. And so they take a large percentage of the mysticism and the religion and the magic and the occult knowledge of the people of the Middle East. Most Freemasons do not even understand that when they circumambulate the lodge with the masters sitting in the east representing the rising sun, that they are practicing an ages-old pagan rite to their true deity, which is the sun, the light, Lucifer. Albert Pike himself revealed the true God of Freemasonry. And he and many others have made the clear statement that Freemasonry is indeed a religion. But it is not the Christian religion. And many of them, fulfilling their oath to remain silent or to lie when the truth is presented to the public or before them, point to the Bible on their altar and say, "See, we are Christians. There's our Bible." What they will not do, ladies and gentlemen, is take you down the street to a lodge in a neighborhood populated by Indian immigrants, and I mean Indians from the Far East, India, on the Indian Ocean, where upon the altar of that Freemasonic lodge is a copy of the Bhagavad Gita. Oh no, they won't tell you that, for they're consummate liars, deceivers, and manipulators. And it amazes me how the public can continue to buy their bullshit for year after year after year after year. After they went to high school, they went to work. Or they went to college for 4 years, where they were indoctrinated into what they are to believe and propound to the general public, and then they went to work for someone else. Amazing. Absolutely pathetic. A nation of children. All dressed like sheep. Yeah, and there used to be a time when the sheeple could go to work and bring home some real money. And they used to save their money. They weren't such sheeple as they are today. It was not considered honorable to be in debt. And if you were in debt, you tried to pay it off as quickly as you possibly could, and you never tried to intentionally go into debt. You had to be forced into debt by some terrible catastrophe that happened to the family. Most people who ever came to this country came with the idea that they would work and save their money until they had enough to start a business of their own. Today, our children are taught that they have to go to school in order to work for somebody else because they are not smart enough to start a business of their own. And the parents help them learn this lesson. For the parents are practicing it themselves. It is pathetic. Absolutely pathetic, a nation of children in sheep's clothing. Pretending to be adults and thinking that they're going to straighten things out and stop this new world order. I get news for you. I have come to my ultimate conclusion. You ain't going to stop nothing. You can't even figure out what's going on in your own neighborhood, much less how to stop this new world order or what to do about it. And so many of you are so absolutely ignorant and stupid that you've already rigged the next election. You've split the vote up so many different ways that I can guarantee you that our enemies are going to win if there is even an election. How many of you are for Perot? How many of you would vote for Colin Powell, the CFR member, the man who's for the United Nations, the man who's for all these other things that are not American? How many of you would vote for Pat Buchanan with all of these oaths of allegiance that he's taken to foreign powers? It has nothing to do with him being a Catholic. I know Catholics all my life who have never taken an oath for anything and don't believe that it's biblically correct to do so. So I don't want any of your stupid sheeple letters accusing me of coming down on Catholics. Or like these jerks on the internet accusing me of attacking the Mormon Church. No, I question the oaths of the leadership of the Mormon Church to wreak revenge upon the United States for the hanging of Joseph Smith. If you listen to the tape I did, you will see that that's exactly what I said. And I question the oaths that they take, which are, in many instances, the exact same oaths that are taken by the Freemasons in their lodge. Blood oaths of allegiance, absolute obedience. If they're going to run for office. Other than that, I don't care what church they belong to. I don't care if they worship dog dung in the middle of the street at midnight. The Constitution protects that. And I believe in the Constitution wholeheartedly. Oh, and when I mentioned the Kol Nidre on the internet and that it was taken by the higher degrees of these secret societies to absolve themselves of allegiance of any other oaths of any kind, oh, here came the knee-jerk reactionary Jews calling me anti-Semitic again. You see, I'm sick of it, folks. You're not going to win anything. You're not going to escape anything, and you're not going to get liberty back. Not at all. You're too stupid to do it. You're too ignorant to do it. You've got too many agendas of your own, most of which are to keep your little fantasies going around you so that you never have to look at the truth and so that you never have to be blamed for anything. But the truth is, if you want to know what's wrong with this country, ladies and gentlemen, go look in the mirror. Go look in the mirror. And you will see exactly what's wrong with the United States of America staring at you in the glass. Absolutely. Patriots? I find very few patriots running around in this country. I find an awful lot of people who call themselves patriots, but who also have agendas. You want to know what a few of them are? Quote, "You're not an American unless you're free, white, and Christian, and own property." There's one. And there's another agenda. Well, there's so many of them, I'm not going to waste any time on it. Everybody has their agenda. And none of it has anything to do with liberty. I was on a liberty list on the internet today. And they were talking about kicking somebody off the list because, and it wasn't me, folks, because he used a lot of what they call inappropriate language. And they were using the excuse that there's a lot of women and children read these posts. Well, I've never known a woman in my life who hadn't heard every single word that anybody could ever come up with. And most of the women I've ever known in my life, when they didn't think anybody was listening, occasionally used a lot of those words. Reminds me of a friend of mine I once had. As a young man, we shared a room in a barracks in the Strategic Air Command at Shepherd Air Force Base, Texas. He got married, went off on his honeymoon, and came back and confided in me that he was absolutely crushed to find out that his wife passed gas. In his whole life, he never thought that women did such things. And children, is this some kind of a joke? I mean, how hypocritical have we gotten, ladies and gentlemen? Every bad thing that I ever learned in my life, I learned from other kids at school. And so did most of you. Every bad thing you ever did in your life, up to a certain point, was done with other kids, or to other kids, or by other kids to you. And all of you things that you're teaching your sons not to do to little girls, you did to little girls when you were that age. And all the things that mothers are teaching their little girls not to do, they did when they were that age. You know, I'm just sick to death of it. I am so sick of the lies and the hypocrisy and the bullshit and the manipulations. And you think that you're going to create a world of liberty and freedom? No, these people are going to enslave you because you must be enslaved, because you've got to be controlled, because you can't control yourselves. You can't decide upon the truth. You can't figure it out to save your life. You can't understand that if you tell a lie, you are participating in all of the lies. And most of you live lives from day to day, hour to hour, minute to minute, week to week, month to month, and year to year. It is incredible. It is so outlandishly incredible. It is almost unbelievable. A nation or world of people who will not use their intelligence are no better than animals who do not have intelligence. Such people are beasts of burden and stakes on the table by choice and consent.
I reach the top and have to stop, and that's what's bothering me. I wanna be a man in America, go right into town, and be just like the other men. I'm tired of moving around. So I wanna be just like you. I wanna walk like you, talk like you too. You being true. And it's like me, can I to be human too? I
I think it is to the great credit of at least a part of humanity that so many people in the history of the world have done so much to try to make man free, to try to make man responsible, to try to make man live the truth. You know, I used to wonder why these people banded together in these secret society to preserve their secret knowledge instead of coming out and educating people and helping people with it. And now I know. It's because even today they'd still be burned at the stake. There's a lot of you out there that would be burning me at the stake if you could, simply because I've thrown the truth in your face and then I've ground it in. I'm beginning to have a much greater respect for the Illuminati than I ever have in the past. You know, they've been telling me for years, Bill, these people will spit on you. We know that you're telling them the truth, but they don't want to hear the truth, and that's why they have to be controlled and manipulated and led to the slaughter. And I always said in my stupidity, no, you're wrong. You see, you've been hiding the truth from them. All you have to do is show them the truth and things will be better. It will change. We'll have a good world, peace on earth. Nobody will have to kill anybody again. We can live in freedom and liberty, responsible with the truth. Boy, what a fool I have been all these years. You know, one of the biggest differences between me and most of you is when I'm wrong and when I'm stupid, I don't let my ego get in the way. I can look in the mirror and I can say, Bill, you're stupid. And you better change your ways. And I do. Because I don't like to be stupid, and I've done it several times in my life. Why in the world did I ever justify hanging my butt out over the cliff? For most of you, I'll never know. Some of you I do know. Some of you are really good people. Most of the good people I know belong to the intelligence service of the Citizens Agency for Joint Intelligence. And there are a few, very few, who don't. But most of you, I'll tell you the truth, after all the misery that you cause those who spend their lives trying to help you, you don't deserve the time of day from any of us. And that's the truth. You're going to get what you deserve. I can assure you of that right now. You're not going to have a savior in the next election. In fact, you are going to ensure that the election is lost to the enemy. And it's going to be the American people who does it, not the enemy. Stupid Americans, ignorant Americans, dummies. Who never have changed their life since high school. If you really want to understand adult society,
And I don't care what you call your society or what level of education you have. Go look at any high school student body. Look at the games they play and the cliques they have and what they spend most of their time doing. And that is the same thing that you'll find in any adult group of people in this nation on any day of the week you want to look. They don't want to go to school. They spend a lot of time trying to keep from going to school. The only reason that they really go to work, most of them, some of them really like their work, most of them is so that they can get a paycheck so that they can party and get laid. Or buy that big car that they wanted, and to hell with what's going on in Washington, D.C. until they take my car or my party away, I'm just really not worried about it. Isn't that the truth? Well, ladies and gentlemen, I found that that's exactly the truth. And when you set out to find the truth, it's not really to find the truth, it's to find validation for what you already believe is the truth. It's to reinforce your fantasies. And you will reject anything that conflicts with your personal interests or your personal agenda. Oh, I've met so many third-degree Freemasons. They got up 3 degrees. They're third on the rung in the Blue Lodge. They don't know anything about the other degrees. I've never taken them, never studied them, don't know what's going on, and they'll swear to you that nothing's going on up there. And they're not the only ones. American workers wonder why they're in the shape that they're in. They're wondering why everybody's leaving for foreign countries. Well, wouldn't you, if you owned a manufacturing plant and you were put in a position where you had to pay somebody $16 an hour to wait for a door to float by on an assembly line and put in 2 bolts, screw them down tight, and then let it go on by? And then listen to these people bitch and complain when they got laid off or when the factory had to close. Because these are trained American workers and they're too old to learn another trade. Well, if that's true, folks, then you really are monkeys. And that's the fact of the matter. If that's all that you could ever do in your life and you consider that to be highly trained, then you haven't got a brain. Monkeys are smarter than you. And police officers sworn to uphold the law, protect and defend the Constitution of their state and of the United States of America, blatantly ignoring the law, stripping the rights from citizens, committing crimes just so they don't lose their job. Afraid that if they lose their job, they won't be able to find another job that pays as well. You make me puke. You talk about gag me with a spoon. I mean, I am sick of this stuff. I'm so sick of it, you're going to see some major changes coming on this broadcast. And in my organizations. I've had it with you. My family and I are going to enjoy life from now on. We're still going to print Veritas, and it's still going to be the best paper in the United States of America, and this is still going to be the best radio broadcast, but it's going to be a lot different than what it has been. And my organization is still going to consist of the best people in this country. collecting information so that we can deal with what's coming. We, meaning me and my people. The rest of you, frankly, my dear Scarlet, can go soak your heads. You're really not worthy of all the great men and women who have laid down their lives and their reputations and suffered great personal attacks, all for you. I don't even come within the width of the universe to even being remotely a fly speck compared to Jesus Christ. And if that man and all his teachings and all that he tried to do ended up crucified on a hill, how in the world did I ever think that I was going to be any different? Or that anybody else is going to be any different? And this is probably the same attitude that the politicians in Washington take. When they listen to their constituents say the government spends too much money, we've got to cut down on the size of the government and on the spending of the government, so they say, okay, we'll cut back. And so they start cutting back, and they start paring down. And they're going to close a government facility in your town. You were the ones that were yelling and screaming about the government spending and the size of the government, but now they're going to close a facility in your town, and you attack them viciously. You tell them they're not going to get reelected if they close that government facility down in your town. Don't you stupid boobs know that everybody in every town in the United States is doing the same damn thing? And that's why government doesn't shrink. Government can't shrink. You can't take something away from fools once you've given it to them, even if the fools know that it should be taken away. So government keeps growing and growing and growing, and it'll keep growing and growing and growing until it just absolutely collapses and a new order will come in. And a despotism will rule. I'm going to tell you what's going to happen. The whole structure is going to collapse into total and absolute chaos. And a lot of these so-called patriots are going to turn into petty little warlords. They're going to rape, loot, and steal. And so are other people who are not even patriots. Some patriots will try to preserve law and order and will be killed in the process. And the ruling elite will simply go underground until it's all finished.
Here we are, some years after.
Seems that somebody at the satellite uplink couldn't handle the truth either, ladies and gentlemen, so they cut us off the satellite. Well, that won't work, because the tape is here and it's going to get out. What's going to happen is this whole structure is going to fall apart into utter and total chaos. The ruling elite are going to go underground and wait it out while everybody up here just kills each other off. Then they'll come back up and establish a despotism. And you will be ruled like the lodge rules its members. You'll be pledged to absolute obedience. And you'd better hope that the despot is a benevolent. You will destroy yourselves and you will get exactly what you deserve. And those of us who don't deserve it and who want to live by the truth will do the best we can for each other. There really isn't anything to do for the rest of you. You go from one dead end to another. You don't like to be in the middle of the river so that you will get to any kind of a destination. You keep getting caught up in these little eddies that spin around and around and around. You are the flotsam and the jetsam of the battle of life. And you're tossed willy-nilly here and there by the tides and the waves and the oceans and the storms. Those of us who fight the battles are the ones who get somewhere. The rest of you, as in all of history, always fall mercy to the victor of the battle. And it never really matters who it is. For whoever it is, as long as you are the sheep, it doesn't matter who they are or what they do, they will always be the wolves. And all of this realization and this pain, I still wish you well. But knowing that it is your nature that you will not do well. You did not make this nation. Great men sticking their lives in the balance made it for you. You have thrown it away. And I hope God has some mercy, and I hope He can really bless you all. Good night.
Lady Luck, the one who now, love so ever. Gosh, the car. She cried. Fortune, do you see the love of growing? Wonder where the truth is going.
Will come to you. If your heart is in your dream, no request is too